So we just came across
Oasis,
which is a date farm.
We're gonna get a date.
And they have date shakes here.
Okay, so we're at Date Gardens, and they definitely have free samples here. Okay, so we don't have to get lunch today. Let's just eat here.
So when I've always pictured Salton Sea, I thought of it like this like abandoned, dry, smelly thing with dead fish everywhere, but it doesn't look that bad at all. It kind of smells rank actually. Okay, it does smell horrid. It smells like
yeah,
dead fish or something dirty. I don't know. Oh my gosh, it reeks. Oh my gosh, there's like dead fish everywhere. Oh my gosh.
Oh my god.
Alyssa, help me. Oh my gosh. Bark. Oh my gosh, that's definitely a dead fish. And there's another one right here. Oh my gosh, they're like everywhere. Oh my gosh, they're literally everywhere. This is all dead fish. Oh my gosh, there's one like right here too. Oh my gosh. Oh wait, no, that's a log. Hold on, let me go down further. That is a dead fish with his missing eyeball.
Oh
my gosh, this is so disgusting. A little truck and a go home with some crazy pops, but don't judge me about what I do, cause maybe you don't wanna hit.
But it's polluted because supposedly, quote, Mexico is dropping their sewage into it.
Yeah, that's what I heard.
I don't know how true it is.
Well, we walked down there today, and it definitely didn't smell right. But I don't.
See, I asked him because I have a derriere skin problem, and I asked all summer long if I could go swimming down there, and they said no.
They said I can do it on my own risk. Yeah.
Fish kill there that was so bad that.
What is a fish kill?
Is that where all the fish die off?
They just die?
What happens is that the oxygen level goes down and the fish die.
Yeah.
And they die by the millions. And 1 year they were like 2 and 3 foot deep on the beach.
Wow. No way. Yeah. Oh, this lady named Pearl something.
No, that's the ship allegedly carrying pearls that was lost in the desert. You see, when the water came through, it closed that off. Then an earthquake closed it off, and it's a dying sea. The water that's going in there is
just
being
sits there, right?
Redistributed to agricultural and city uses.
Mm-hmm.
And as a result, the condensation of that water causes the salt to come up. Parts per million increases as the water level goes down. The salt, of course, part per million increases exponentially. And so we've got it really, really salty now. And it's not, the sea is dying. And
these puzzles?
Yeah.
Oh,
wow.
Oh,
are they
cool.
Nice?
Yeah, those are really nice.
Beautiful coloring. Yeah. Thank you, Leonard.
Probably half an hour.
Well, thanks for coming.
Oh, you're welcome.
You've had a tour before?
No, it's our first time being here.
Yeah.
I think I'm getting another tour started.
Cool.
And I'd like to show you inside of this museum.
Cool.
Perfect.
I've had 400 cameras a day come in every day that is nice for weeks and weeks. 400 a day or more.
Wow.
And they donate paint and cameras and taking pictures of it.
Mm-hmm.
So the whole thing is getting popular.
Yeah.
And I'm getting excited about it. I found a truck tire in the desert and I filled it full of adobe.
Pictures.
Wow.
10 car tires were adobe.
Wow.
And I poke sticks into the adobe. And it hardened in like a smack block. It's tougher than a boot.
Yeah,
you feel
wow.
How tough it is.
It's nice and cool in here.
Oh, yeah, that's tough. Yeah.
That's here. is a tractor tire tree.
Wow.
The bigger the tires, the bigger the tree.
Yeah.
So these are, I'm confused, these are not real trees?
No, they're tires. They're made of tires.
Come along, wow. Ratchet. Yeah. There's an archway I made with almost 1,000 flowers in there, I think. Because it's kind of fun poking the flowers and they don't cost anything.
Yeah.
And it gets tough.
So what made you decide to come out here? Ooh, oh. Gross. So you're from Vermont. What made you come out to the desert? What brought you out here?
I grew up here in 84. You can check it on the internet.
You broke down, like your car?
And I was going to stay 1 week and make an 8-foot monument. 30 years later, I'm still here. You know, telling the churches, don't get so complicated with love. Love everybody and love and keep it simple.
There's a tear in my beer, cause I'm crying for you, dear.
So we're at the ski inn and we just ordered some beers. And
it's 9:30 in the morning.
I'm gonna keep drinking until I'm petrified, and then maybe these tears will leave my eyes.
Alyssa, this beach looks way cleaner than the one we were at yesterday. There's no dead fish. Yeah, I know. It's probably full of, like, dead fish guts. I've never seen water this brown in my life.
Pin lights that would just flash on the page, and I'd go, you know, what was happening was, is what my mind, well, I didn't know at the time, but now I know, my mind was being picked up. I was seeing things on a different level, and something, I saw something glistening in the corner of my eye. You know how when you're walking around and you see a moon? And I looked, and there was a tree in my front yard. And I looked over there, and it was totally made of crystal. Existence of that tree was crystalline. That was the true nature of the higher isotope of the atom. You'll evolve and evolve over and over, and then you'll be able to graduate. You'll be able to go to a different world, a higher world, and on and on and on. It's like a... Then you could be a teacher like Jesus and go to different worlds that are lower than this one.
The earth or is
this
somewhere else?
This will actually be cities here.
Wow.
This is...
So is this what you were talking about with the tree was crystallized? It's like everything's kind of...
Yeah.
Wow.
But you're actually looking at cities and temples. And this represents...
Or the temple, like, in the center of each city, is that what... Okay.
And it's different schools. Different schools that people will go to, you know, to learn New Age principles. And the tower that's in the middle is actually a power tower. Everything will be wireless electricity. Energy aura around you, too.
Cool.
It's
I like thinking of it that way.
I felt it when I saw you guys in the parking lot.
Yeah. You pick up on that?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. But yeah, these... Soon, very soon, as planet Earth progresses and becomes more open to spiritual new things, we're going to meet these people. They will land here. And the information that Unarius has received is there'll be like 33 spaceships, starships, that'll actually land here on top of each other and will form a university. And they say it'll land in Humboldt.
Where is it?
Humboldt.